Hello, today we will discuss about SDS polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis. It is a very important technique for students of paramedical and medical subject, since you can prepare many projects related to your dissertations as a part of your semester examinations. This technique is also very important for those paramedical individuals who are planning to become entrepreneurs. You will be able to make Western blot diagnostic strips if you understand basics of SDS page electrophoresis very well. SDS page electrophoresis means sodium dodecyl sulfate polyacrylamide gel electrophoresis. It is used to fractionate various proteins on the basis of their molecular size and weight. Basic principle of electrophoresis I have already explained in my previous video on dot blot techniques, so don't forget to see that. And the principle of electrophoresis is also very well explained in all our books. And the principle is again I have placed on the left hand side. Let us first understand the importance of basic components of SDS page system. First, sodium dodecyl sulfate, SDS. SDS is a detergent which denatures the proteins. It is combined with a reducing agent like mercaptoethanol, and by the combined action of SDS and mercaptoethanol, proteins unfold into linear chains. That means their tertiary structure is converted to primary structure. Next, the very important component for electrophoresis is a neutral medium on which proteins are fractionated. Earlier we have seen use of agarose gel and nitrocellulose papers. In this case, polyacrylamide gel is used. It is combined with bisphenylacrylamide and mixed with catalyst of ammonium persulfate and TEMED, that means N tetramethyl ethylene diamine. So these components form a stable gel with molecular sieving property. That means the gel contains large number of small holes which allow small proteins to pass at faster rate, and fractionation of proteins get further effective with the main electrical effect. Two gels are used. First part contains 6% in the stacking part of the gel and 12% in the running, that means separating part of the gel as shown in the figure. A comb is used to make wells on the gel where serum or plasma samples can be applied for electrophoresis. And then another very important requirement is the buffer system. Two buffers are used, and these buffers are one for the stacking part, that is trisglycine HCl pH 6.8, and other one is for the running and separating part of the gel, and that buffer is trisglycine HCl pH 8.8. And the preparation of various solutions I have placed on the left hand side. Other requirements are polyacrylamide gel support glass plates, electrophoresis tank and electrophoresis power supply pack, and one dye is also required, and that is bromophenol blue dye. It is usually mixed with serum samples and it is used as a tracking dye. It moves at a faster rate during electrophoresis than the proteins, and from its mobility it is possible to find out to what extent the proteins have moved. Now let us understand the importance of stacking part of the polyacrylamide gel and when buffer is used at pH 6.8. At this particular pH, chloride ions move at a faster rate, being negatively charged, and they are small molecular weight ions. Glycine, on the other hand, at pH 6.8 behaves very much like butyrene and only slightly negatively charged and moves at very slow rate, while proteins behave like negatively charged particles and move in between glycine and chloride ions as shown in the figure. In this manner, all the proteins gather at the base of the stacking gel and on the top of the separating gel and start moving at the same time in the downward direction. Now, in the separating part of the gel, negatively charged chloride ions again move at a faster rate, and glycine now at pH 8.8 behaves like negatively charged particle and also moves at a faster rate and follows chloride ions, while proteins which are larger in size also behave like negatively charged particles and move according to their respective molecular weight and sizes and then get separated at the end of the electrophoresis. Now let us see how the electrophoresis procedure is performed. 1. Two glass plates are placed in the casting mold with a space of about 1 mm and casting mold is clamped and checked for water leakage and then dried. Next, freshly prepared 12% acrylamide gel mix is added in between the glass plates till a mark for stacking gel, and on the top of it 200 microliter of isopropanol is added, and the gel is allowed to polymerize and it takes about 30 minutes. Next, 6% of freshly prepared acrylamide gel mix is added on the top of 12% polymerized acrylamide gel, and then a comb is placed and then the gel is allowed to polymerize. It takes about 30 minutes. Then Tris glycine HCl buffer pH 8.8 is added in the outer compartment up to the mark as shown in the figure. Similarly, Tris glycine HCl buffer is also added in the inner compartment as shown in the figure till the top of the specimen marks. Next, the specimen serum or plasma 40 microliter is mixed with 40 microliter of the buffer and heated for 3 minutes and centrifuged and supernatant is removed. It is important to note here that the serum or plasma samples are heated at 100 degrees temperature to further break their disulfide linkages. Next, serum or plasma is mixed with bromophenol blue dye and 10 microliter of the mixture is applied for electroporotic run as shown in the figure, and then the lid of the buffer tank is closed, and by applying 12 milliamperes per one plate or 200 volts electrical current is passed through the polyacrylamide gel and electrophoresis procedure is continued till bromophenol blue mark appears at the bottom of the gel. After the completion of the procedure, the gel is removed and placed in Kumasi blue staining solution in a square petri dish as shown in the figure, and it is incubated at 50 degrees centigrade for 30 minutes. Next, it is placed in dish staining solution 2% acetic acid till the background of the gel becomes clear and bands look visible and they will appear as shown on the left hand side. And after drying at room temperature, then the gel is scanned for the bands using a densitometer. Now let us discuss, as an entrepreneur, how to prepare Western blot strips. We will consider making of Western blot strips for the confirmatory detection of HIV. For that matter, you need following requirements. 1. See DNA of HIV. This can be obtained by PCR technology from HIV patients' white blood cells. And for this matter, watch our video on dot blot techniques. 2. Pads and nitrocellulose membrane strips as shown on the left hand side. And 3. All the requirements of PAGE electrophoresis as I have described earlier. Now let us see the procedure. The procedure is like this. First, fractionate cDNA antigen proteins by PAGE electrophoresis as I have described earlier. Then do not stain the gel. Instead, transfer the fractionated proteins to nitrocellulose membrane as shown on the left hand side, and then cut the strip appropriately. The strip is ready like this, and it has all antigenic proteins of HIV fractionated. Using this strip, you can determine patient's HIV antibodies as follows. First, take patient's serum in a test tube. Then place HIV Western blot paper in the tube and incubate at 37 degrees centigrade for 15 minutes. If antibodies are present in the patient's serum, they will bind with specific antigenic proteins of HIV. Now wash the strip using a wash buffer solution. Afterwards, add a buffer containing anti-human antibodies tagged with peroxidase enzyme and incubate for 15 minutes at 37 degrees temperature for about 15 minutes. Then again wash with wash buffer, and afterwards add hydrogen peroxide substrate and tetramethyl benzene. If HIV antigens and antibody complexes are formed, then peroxidase will act on hydrogen peroxide and liberated oxygen will oxidize tetramethyl benzene, and blue bands will appear corresponding to specific HIV antigens as shown on the left hand side. Well, you can prepare large number of Western blot strips for various viruses and viral antigenic proteins by using this method. I take this opportunity to thank all of you for using your lockdown time in learning and updating your educational knowledge. Next time I will bring you one more educational video. So thanks once again and take care. All the best.